Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Open Green Energy. In this video, we will make a upgraded version of my earlier multifunction energy meter. The new version of multifunction energy meter have few additional functionalities, like you can monitor the parameters from your smartphone. I have also added a USB port to test the USB devices. You can also use this device to monitor the power generation from a small solar panel. The solar panel rating shall be less than 50 watt. So without any further delay, let's get started. At first, I have prepared the female header for Wemos board, OLED display and INA219. I cut the female header as per their pin number. After preparing the female header, I soldered them on a perforated board. After soldering all the female header onto the perforated board, I am checking whether all the bolts are perfectly fits or not. Then I soldered 3 screw terminals. One is for source connection, another one is for load, and the final one is for connecting the power supply to the Wemos board. Then I soldered a sliding switch. At last, I am going to add a USB port. To mount the USB port, you have to make 2 holes. The hole size should be slightly larger than the normal hole given in the perforated board. After inserting the USB port, I secured the 2 legs by using a screwdriver. After soldering all the female headers and terminals, you have to make the circuit. You can make the circuit by using the schematic diagram. The schematic diagram is given on my website. The link to download this schematic is given in video description. At last, I am soldering the temperature sensor. I forgot to solder it. You can solder it earlier. insulate the conductive part of the circuit from the ground, I have used 4 PCB standoff. To power the circuit, here I am using a 700 mAh LiPo battery pack. The battery pack is mounted on the back side of the circuit board by using a 3M double-sided tape. Then I connect the battery terminal wire to the battery's Q terminal. During the connection, be sure the polarity is correct. After that, I insert all the modules along with Wemos board. At last, I mount the temperature sensor. The pin diagram for the temperature sensor is shown in the video. Now our circuit board is ready. We have to upload the Arduino code into the Wemos board. Open the Arduino IDE, then select the correct board and COM port number. You can download the Arduino code from my website. The link is given in video description. Then you have to import all the libraries. After installing all the libraries into your sketch, you have to enter the Blink Auth ID, SSID and password of your Wi-Fi router. Now upload the code by hitting the upload button. You can use my Blink app by scanning the QR code. The link to download the QR code is given in video description. To test the circuit board, I am using a lead acid battery as a source and a 3-watt LED as a load. You can see the OLED display, all the parameters are displayed. You can also get all the parameters on your smartphone by opening the Blink app. You can change the parameter into the auto range mode by pressing the auto range button. You can use this device as a USB capacity tester. Now I am going to use this device to monitor the solar power generation. Here I am using a 10 watt solar panel. You can notice I am getting very less power from a 10 watt solar panel because it is sunset time. The solar panel is not getting sufficient sunlight. Guys, if you are new to my channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you will get notified whenever I upload a new video. Thank you.